neighbor. This is Pastor Jimmy proclaiming the truth with words of encouragement. God is still on the throne. The Bible is the Word of God. And Jesus is coming soon. I say that every week. It sure would be nice if he would come back today, solve a lot of my problems and solve a lot of your problems. Well, today I want to talk to you about, will my religion get me to heaven? I have people today that I'm this, I'm that. They think their religion is going to get them to heaven. Turn in your Bible to Matthew 7:21, and let's see what the Bible has to say about heaven. In 7:21, the Bible says, "Not everyone that saith unto me, Lord, Lord, shall enter into the kingdom of God," our kingdom of heaven, "but he that doeth the will of my Father which is in heaven. Many will say to me in that day, Lord, Lord, have we not prophesied in thy name, and in thy name cast out devils, and in thy name done many wonderful works?" Now notice what the Lord says in verse number 23. He says, "And then I will profess unto them, I never knew you." Underline that word, "I never knew you." Not that he once knew you, but he says, "I never knew you. Depart from me that work iniquity." See, those people that were talking about, they done this and they done that, that's works. You're not saved by works. You're saved by the grace of God. For by grace are you saved, through faith, not of works, lest any man should boast. You can't work yourself to heaven. How long would you have to work if you begin to work? And so I'd like to talk to you about who's going to heaven. We all know all the Bible teaches the reality of heaven and the reality of hell. Jesus himself spoke of both places many times. He spoke about heaven and he spoke about hell. Actually, he spoke more on hell than he did heaven. And all of us, I'm sure, would like to go to heaven if we could. Now, if you're born again, you're going. If you're not born again, you're not going. Even if you're not a Christian, I'm sure if you had a choice, you'd say, "I'd like to go to heaven instead of hell." Whatever it is and wherever it is, listen to me. I'd rather go to heaven than hell any day of my life. But you see, a lot of people don't even believe in hell. But that's sad. There is a hell. I begin with a very simple observation. Not everyone, notice this, write it down. Not everyone is going to heaven. Jesus said, "Wide is the gate and broad is the road that leads to destruction. And many enter through it, but small is the gate and narrow is the road that leads to life, and only few find it." That's found in Matthew 7:13. Listen to the "enter into the straight gate," he says. Here is a line from an old Negro spiritual that says it well. And here's what he says. Everybody's talking about heaven ain't going there. Everybody that is talking about heaven ain't going there. That's what the old Negro spiritual had to say. A lot of people talk about heaven, but like he said, they ain't going there. Lots of people talk about heaven. Most of them think they're going there. But that's not what Jesus said. There are two roads in life. One leads to heaven, the other leads to hell. There are many there are many on the road to hell, and only they don't know it. A lot of people don't know they're going to hell. They think that they're a good person. They think that they're religious. This means that millions of good, decent, religious people who think they're going to heaven will one day find out how wrong they were. My second observation is most people believe that good people go to heaven. Yeah, I talk to people all the time. Yeah, so-and-so is going to heaven. According to one poll, now listen to this, 53% of the Americans agree that good works can earn a place in heaven. 53% people believe that good works will get them into heaven. So I ask the question, will good people go to heaven? I believe I have the answer, and the answer is no. Is this message, in this message, I'm going to share four reasons why good people won't go to heaven. Four reasons why good people won't go to heaven. Now look at this. John chapter 3, verses 1 through 7. Jesus was talking to a man called Nicodemus. Nicodemus was a very religious Pharisee, very religious. He was a ruler of the Jews. This man came to Jesus by night. He was curious and said unto him, Rabbi, which means teacher, we know that thou art teacher come from God, for no man can do these miracles that you do except God be with him. Now, you don't need to be trusting your religion and your traditions to get you to heaven. You need to put your trust in the Lord Jesus Christ. But here's a religious man that came to Jesus by night. Tradition tells us four things we need to know about Nicodemus. Now, I want you to listen carefully about this religious leader named Nicodemus. First of all, Nicodemus was rich. He was a very rich man. Nicodemus, secondly, was respectable. Thirdly, Nicodemus was very religious because the Pharisees knew the Word of God. But fourthly, Nicodemus was lost. Rich, respectable, religious, but lost. Just because, neighbor, you are rich and respectable and religious doesn't mean that you're going to heaven. I talk to people all the time, say, I hope so. I'll be on the phone sometime and I'll start to get off the phone and I'll say, let me ask you a question. If you were to die today, would you go to heaven? Well, I hope so. Well, see, you don't need a hope so salvation. You need a know so salvation. And you can know because 1 John 5:13 says, these things have I written unto you that you may know. What? That you may know that you have eternal life. How do you have that? He that hath the Son hath life. He that hath not the Son hath the wrath of God abiding on. And just because you're rich and respectable doesn't mean that you're going to heaven. Actually, Nicodemus was a good man. You would think that him being a religious leader, he was going to heaven. Not so. Nicodemus was lost. How do you know he was lost? Well, listen, neighbor. Jesus told him that he needed to be born again. That's how I know. And if Jesus says you need to be born again, you need to be born again. I needed to be born again. You need to be born. The only way that you can go to heaven is that if thou shalt confess with thy mouth the Lord Jesus and believe in thy heart that God has raised him from the dead, thou shalt be saved. You need to repent of your sins. You need to say, dear Lord, I'm sorry for my sin of rejecting you as my Savior. And then you confess him with your mouth and believe in your heart that God has raised him from the dead. And neighbor, you can be saved. For the Bible says, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believe him shall not perish, but have what? Everlasting life. Nicodemus needed to be born again. And you and I needed to be born again. And if you're listening to this broadcast this morning, if you do not know the Lord as your personal Savior, if you've never been born again, if you've never said yes to Jesus and asked him to forgive you of your sin, what can wash away my sins? Nothing but the blood of Jesus. What can make me whole again? Nothing but the blood of Jesus. Ladies and gentlemen, without the shedding of blood, there's no forgiveness of sin. So if you want to go to heaven, here's how. Trust in the Lord. You know, one of my favorite verses of the Bible is in Proverbs chapter 3, 5 through 7. It says, trust in the Lord with all thy heart, and lean not to thy own understanding. In all thy ways acknowledge him. Listen to me. Trust the Lord. That means have confidence in him. That means to believe in him. That means to rely upon him with all your heart, with all your soul, with all your might. And then he says, flee sin. Let's turn from sin to the Savior. Matter of fact, the Bible says, if a man be in Christ, he's a new creature. You know, a lot of people today say, I'm saved, but they live like the devil. Now, I'm not saying a Christian doesn't sin, because they do. All of us sin. By matter of fact, the Bible says, if we say we have no sin, the truth's not in us. And we call God a liar. Neighbor, we don't want to be calling God a liar. We want to confess our sins and trust in Christ. And that way, the moment that you said, dear Jesus, come into my heart, forgive me my sin, you're going to heaven. Got a ticket. There's a song out there. I think it's by Dottie Rambo. Anyway, had to get some help from the audience. Jesus is your ticket to heaven. Jesus is your, listen, the only way you're going to go to heaven is by Jesus Christ. Now, as we close, I want you to know, I want you to find you a good Bible preaching church and get involved. And may your troubles be less, may your blessings be more, and may nothing but happiness come here. Listen, happiness comes from the Lord. Joy comes from the Lord. And please don't forget to tell somebody about Jesus. Until next time, neighbor, I'll see you here, there, or in the air.